No.
Can I test myself to know that I do not delude myself?
How can he test himself to know that he's not deluding himself? You mean?
All right. Now, see, now, it's a very simple thing, is that you should, there are two complications always arise. When you feel the vibrations yourself, you see, then you might delude yourself by thinking these are mine or of the other person. Am I feeling the chakras of another person or my chakras? Now, supposing you want to know about another person, what you have to do is give a bandhan to that person and see the chakras, what chakras are catching, all right? Now, supposing, say, this chakra is catching. You ask that person, are you suffering from throat trouble? He'll tell you, yes. So you will know this is what he's suffering from. Now, relatively, you have to understand also whether your vibrations are correct or not. For example, now, you ask a question, is there God? Which is a fundamental question. Supposing you ask a question, is there a God? Then you get the vibrations, all right? But supposing you ask about somebody, is this a good man? You don't get a good vibrations. Then you are not deluded because you see that's an absolute fact you have known and that's a relatively is not so. Like you go somewhere, now somebody might say that this statue is made by a realized soul. Now how will you make it out? Whether it is made by a realized soul or not by a realized soul. You put your hands towards the photograph, all right? And ask the question, is it made by a realized soul? Maybe without asking the question, if you are sensitive enough, vibrations will start flowing into you. Now the thing is, you must know that delusion and all this only come when we have some greed about it or some lust about it. If there is no lust and greed, it is just pure feeling of cool breeze is coming from somewhere, then you cannot be deluded. But the feeling of this cool breeze to feel on your fingers, you have to develop a little more sensitivity because this is a subtle feeling while we are rising from the gross to the subtle. When that subtleness grows in us nicely, then you will be sure that you have got it. So first thing is that you must go into a state where there is no delusion left. That's why the first one I said is the state of nirvikara, nirvichara, where it is there is no thought. And when you go beyond that is the state of nirvikalpa, where there is no doubts, you are sure about it. There is no delusion anymore. You know, because so many times you have used it, you are so much perfected in experiencing it that you know. Experiencer has to be awakened within us in such a way that he always gives you the right answer. But in the beginning will be a problem, I agree with you, because you will think that these are my vibrations or her vibrations. But some people don't even have that. I have seen it. Some people don't have any diligence. Immediately, like little children, immediately they will say, this person has got this catching, that is catching, this is that. But with others, it has a little problem in the beginning, no doubt, isn't it? It has. So we must accept that. And in that case, you have to just be serious about it, respect your realization, grow into it, your delusion.